A pentagonal prism of base h 25 mm and height 60 mm is rest in HP on its base with one of the base edge is inclined 45 degree to VP. For that we will start to draw this with the help of XY line. This will be the XY. Plot any point and from that point I need to take 45 degree inclination. See, here it is VP and this one is the HP. So take the inclination 45 degree in HP. Right? In HP, draw 45 degree inclination. Now with this inclination, what we need to do, either you can form here on this side pentagon or this side. I will form on this side. So this is the 25 mm, right? So what we have to do, we need to make 108 degree from each corner. Measure from here 108. And similarly, from the another end, measure from this side 100, 108. So these are the two points. So mark here 25 mm. This point. Similarly, on this side, mark 25 mm. Now, take this distance 25 mm, and by this distance from these corners, I need to form end point. So this will be the point. Simply connect it so that we will complete. Now to find the center point of this one, either you find the center point by means of median. So median is the perpendicular from the opposite corner. So somewhat here and here also. Now this is the point where OO dash is there. Is it? Axis. Now I need to name it. So the top face. For the top face, so if I put this in this way, the top face and this one is the bottom face. For the bottom face, we will name it as A, B, C, D and E. And the top face, we will name it as 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Remember these terms. Now see. The height is of 60 mm. That means 1A in the front view is of 60 mm. So we will mark over here. Directly we will form 60 mm distance. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here it is. This edge is of 1A. 1A, which is of 60 mm. Now I will draw one parallel line from the top face right now. Now here, remember that we need to draw the lines in this way, hide this portion, 5e visible, so draw here 5e. Now this rectangle is formed, 1 5 EA. If line comes under this, we need to show it by a dotted line, right? So move further. Here it is the 4D. So we will project this 4D. Now two rectangles are formed. Now see here. This comes inside the already formed rectangle. So we need to show it by a dotted line. This should be 3C. And similarly, at this location, 2B by means of dotted line. And here it is a center line. Now the next part, a sectional cutting plane inclined 70 degree to HP. Right, so I will form here 70 degree from this point, 70 degree to HP, right? So whenever inclination is given with HP, we need to place that inclination in VP. So this will be the inclination, 70 degree with HP, right? Now move further. And passing through a point on axis which is 30 mm above HP, so 30 mm above, I need to mark a point which is 30 mm above on axis, 1, 2, 3 on axis, right? This is the point, 30 mm above on axis, right? So I need to place this inclination somewhat over here. See? Right? Okay. So I will form over here. Wait. Followed by a center line. Now this will be the cutting portion. We need to remove the upper part and we need to keep the lower part as it is. So basically, what we can do, we will highlight the remaining part, which we are going to keep as it is. Now this part we will keep as it is. Right, so whenever the top face or bottom face, I will call this as a top face and this as a bottom face, whenever top face or bottom face cut by a sectional plane, whenever top face or bottom face cut by a section plane, immediately draw one vertical line. One vertical line throughout the top view. See, in this way. Throughout the top view. So I have created throughout the top view two lines. We keep this portion as it is and we have removed this one. That means this will be the section plane. This will be the section. Now we need to find the points, right? So here the points we will get over here. Since top face is cut, I will name it as P3, right? P3, and here it is 2. On line 2, 3, there will be point 2. So I will name it as P2, 3. This is the point P5, 4. I am telling you about this point. This point is at the top face, right? So on the top face there will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So these points which belongs to top face only. So here it is 2, here it is 3. So this point will be P2, 3, and this point will be P5, 4. Next one. This is the point 5E. So here only you will get point P5. Right? Now, this is P3. Here, see, here it is P3. This one is the P5. And this one is the P2, 3. And P54. Two points, single point, single point. Again, here you will get 2 points. See? Now, this is the base of face, right? So, on the base, you will get A, B, C, D, E, right? So, this point will be P, A, E, because on line A, E, it is, and on line AB this point is, that's why I will call it as PAB. So here are PAB and PAE. These are the points, right? Now what remains inside of this portion we keep as it is. So I will highlight this. This will be the required sectional top view. So this should be a sectional top view. This should be a sectional front view. Right? Now, next theme, we need to copy this section over here to get the true shape. And for that, take the distance. I will take this as a first point. Right? So PAE and PAB, this point is. The next point is of P3. So take the distance over here. You will get here point P3, right? After that PE, here it is. P5, and the next one is of P2, 3 and 5, 4. P2, 3 and P5, 4. Now we need to project these points in the top view. Cross this with the parallel projection. This will be the P2. Wait. This will be the point P2. P2 is there. P2. P2. Right? Now project this. you will get here P2. This will be the P23, PAB. So simply you need to follow this one. Right. So this will be the point AE, PAB, P2, P23, P54, and here it is P5. If you connect these points sequentially, then we will form here one closed loop, which is nothing but true shape of section. Right? So this will be the true shape of section. Now to form development of surfaces, we need to project these points simply. So project this as it is. And now what we have to do? See, I will take first point over here. And if I call this as 1A, now you have to take 25 mm distance, and with this you need to mark it 5 times, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now draw vertical lines from this, 2, 3. 4, 5, and this one is the again 1. A, B, C, D, E, and again A. 2, 3, 4, 5, and again 1. Now from the top view you need to take these points. Right? I will get only P2 and P5 from these lines. So remember, I will get P5 directly over here, P5, and P2 here only, P2. So these points you can generate. Now what we have to do, we need to generate these points, right? And for that, what you have to do, you need to take the distance from here. I have taken distance from 3, from 3 to 0.23, from 3 for 0.23. So here you will get point P23. Similarly, from D you will get here point P54. From 4 we need to generate, from 4 we need to generate P54. So here it will be P54, these two points. Okay. Now next theme, see, these are the bottom points, right? So bottom point is of E, and we have taken AE. So where it AE, AE is here. I have taken distance from E for point PAE. PAE. Similarly, look here. From point B, I have taken distance of PAB. From point B, I have taken distance of point PAB. Now the tedious task. See. In the this one, 1A, we have removed. See, 1A we have removed. We keep this much portion only of this 2b, out of 2b, this much portion will remain, this much portion. Now out of this much portion we keep as it is. We keep 3 and 4 also as it is. So I will form this. See, 3 and 4 uncut. So this 3 and 4 uncut. Now we are having these points, right? So simply connect it. So this will be the development. See, these are the lines which remain inside the component, so that I need to generate this curve. Okay? So remember how I have generated PAB and PAE. P23 and P54. P23 and P54 belongs to the top face, and PAB and AE belongs to the bottom face. Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much.